Welcome to Let's Play. Wait for it. And you got the title anyway. Isle of the Dead. You're probably not familiar with this game. I wouldn't be surprised. I didn't know about this game until a couple hours ago or so. This music, it sounds great, doesn't it? Get used to it, sadly. From the bit that I've played through this, it doesn't go away. It's pretty much this the entire time. I've already taken a take of this, but apparently my sound mix turned off in Windows, and I lost my game sound, and I was talking about the sound and whatnot, and that, anyway, turn speed goes from 10 to 5, and then to 2 to 1. Apparently in this universe, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, and 9 don't exist. For the most part, you don't want to use 10. 5 seems most comfortable. Play level 1, 2, and 3. I don't know what that does. I don't know which way is easy, and I don't know which way is hard, so we'll leave it on 2. I'm not going to shut the music off. We're not going to shut the sound off. And this is a save game. Obviously, I've made a few. Let's save right now. Controls in this game are actually kind of weird. Alt increases speed, which I think is just the turn thing. Control slash right mouse button, you'll strafe. Or you can hold control and the other button. Actually, no, that's, you know, you hold it and then push the thing. Because you use the arrow keys, but you can also use the mouse to move, which is a little bit weird. For the most part, if you're in combat, you should actually use both. It's a little weird to get used to. You gotta play it for a while to get used to. But I find that that's the best way to, play this game. There's a joystick, but I have a controller, but these L I U, yeah, you don't need these. Really, the W you do need, cause option zoom map, you don't really need that. Show map rather, zoom, you don't need that. Why? Because if I bring up the map, you see that. Well, that doesn't look too bad, does it? But the thing is that's the only bit it shows. I'm not kidding. I mean, I can keep playing this game. And if I go to another section, it will show that square and this one will go away. So the map is completely worthless. Unless you draw one, then you can actually get something out of it. You can pick stuff up with the middle mouse button like I just did there. I prefer to use G. It works better in my opinion. Anyway, we just picked up a jacket. Look at the jacket, we'll find some smoke some lighters? No, a lighter. We're going to need those. Also, we can go into the burning plane and pick up some wire cutters. There's more stuff in here, namely machete, which we're going to need to get through the jungle. Also, we need this book. There's a flare gun, which, from as far as I've played in the game, that I haven't figured out. As you've noticed, this is actually a first-person shooter with point-and-click aspects to it. A little bit weird. Also, on any of these screens, you can't save. Just kind of crappy. Anyways, if we hit W, it brings out our machete, and we can chop with it. Yes. Anywho, let's pick up a coconut. And move around a bit more. There are some things over here, namely another coconut. And, well, it's a zombie game. Of course there's going to be ammo of the shotgun. I mean, it's required, isn't it? You could make a zombie game without the shotgun, but that would just be weird. Would anyone play a zombie game without the shotgun? I don't think so. See, this actually leads to a cave, but we're not going to go there yet. We're actually going to go somewhere way, 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 way down the path. Because we're going to get a weapon. There's another weapon actually in that cave that I just went by, that I pointed out. But we'll get that one after. There's a lot of death in this game. The death animations are wonderful. I'm not going to pass judgment on this game till I beat it. Which, might be a while, since, if you look this game up, it doesn't have any walkthroughs on GameFAQs. Also, if you get really close to the water, it looks terrible. Not to mention this island's, like, perfectly square. Anyway, from the review... Did I talk about the reviews I found of this game? One of them was rated 0 out of 5 stars, which... honestly, what? Rate a game 0? That's mean. I'd give someone at least, you know, 10% just from getting together every day to make a game. I'll give you, you know, 10 free points for effort. After that, I'm gonna go in ascending order. The next review I found of this game gave it 13 out of 100. Yes. Get another coconut, and of course, Le Shotgun. The next one I found, it's a good time to save. The next one I found was glowing reviews at 38 out of 100. The one after that was its best one. Whoa, mate. When you go into a new area, make sure you have a real weapon equipped. The next one was 3.5 stars out of 5, which is about 70%, which is still not really all that good. Out of 4 scores that I could find, it had 1 passing grade. And that one wasn't a very good passing grade. Is there anything actually in here? Hello? I missed? You die, please. I need to turn my volume down a little bit on my speakers. Anywho. Yeah. Believe it or not, the shotgun is not the most useful weapon. Oh yes, this child, he wants to eat your brains. Thankfully, you're a lot faster than pretty much everything in the game. He also seems to be one of the weakest enemies. There's some shotgun shells, so this alone is going to make it worth it, since we came in here with 50, and now I have 50. 52, 51, now I have 76, so I did gain a little bit. Yes, I see you. Stop that. Yes, I'm playing an FPS, but it's old and isn't all that great, so I guess you can take that for what it's worth. Just so you know, this game does indeed hate you. If I leave this area, turn around and come back in, all the zombies will be back. So let's kill that one, and kill the fat guy. Yes, and pick up some lovely bananas. So all that, I gained a couple bananas and 8 shotgun shells. That's not a bad trade for a couple minutes, I'd have to say, but we don't ever need to come back in here, thankfully. Yeah, I suppose we should go get the next weapon. All the way back at that, rock. Oh, I gotta show me dying to, zombies. It's quite a nice animation. He lied. Options, save game, 2. There we go. Show me dying to zombies, since I'm going to die anyway. Oh, it didn't do it. Yeah, this game has no checkpoints whatsoever. No matter where I die, I could be right at the end of the game, and it'll port me right here at the start. So you actually do need the save function a lot. Also, I didn't mention this, but you can move forward and back by doing the same motion with the mouse. It feels kind of weird to me, though, so I'm not going to do it. I just saved the 2, right? Yes. Okay. Let's move on. The place we're going next is this way. To the silver-looking rock. Actually, shouldn't I have more ammo than this? Did I miss something? I don't know. Backtracking! Whee! Where is that thing? Is it in the, around the corner? Or... I'm sorry, I've played through this little bit of section like 3 times and I still don't remember what I'm doing. This is going to be mostly blind. If you go on GameFAQs, there's actually not a review for this. There's like 2 screenshots and that's it. It's rather pathetic. And the thing is I spent about an hour looking for, you know, any maps for this, just in case I needed them. I wouldn't, you know, really study them, but I would, you know, try to at least do the whole game somewhat blind, but, you know, if I got stuck, I'd have something to fall back on. No, I can't find any maps. I spend a lot of time looking. If you can find some and send them to me while I'm still doing this game, I'd appreciate it if you want to go through the effort. Anyway, let's go in this cave. There's a gun! Let's grab it! An old rifle! Get, please! And we explode, turn into ash, and die. Yes, let's not do that and do what we're supposed to do, like loading 3 save, and go back in the cave. Anyway, there's a little gray pixel-high thing. What we're supposed to do is go in our inventory, click use, and the item. I would think you... I was trying to do it the other way around before, and it just doesn't work. Anyway, let's get this rifle. I know I ruined that right at the start. Look, see some crates of ammo. Let's get them. Is there any more? No, sadly. This guy, we cannot pick him up. Hello? Talk to you? No? Yeah, he doesn't want to talk. Anyway, that's the way out. We don't want those. We actually want this. And I'm trying to talk to oil in a rag. It doesn't work. Let's get those and get out of here. That pretty much takes care of that, so we don't need to go back in there. Time for some more saving and more death. Yes. How am I going to die? I will show you. Yes, the gun doesn't work and it blows up in our face and blows us off at the torso with some sort of rifle round. I don't know how that works, but I'm going to go with it. Did I really do what I think I just did? I loaded the wrong one, I hope. Yes, I did. Okay, we have 75 rifle rounds and 58 shotgun rounds. Believe it or not, from my experience, the rifle actually hits harder. Which is kind of strange. But, can't really complain about that. Anyway, what we're supposed to do with this baby is to use the oil on the rag. Use oil on rag. Then, we're going to use the rag on the old rifle so it doesn't blow up in our faces. No! Also, there seems to be a little space between the rifle and the shotgun, so I assume there's one more weapon, but I have no idea where it would be. Anyway, let's head back to the plane, which is right over here, and it has stopped burning. And it looks like it's been there a while now. Anyway, yeah, here comes the part where I don't... Oh, weapon. Oh, I'm being nommed. Don't nom me, please. Go away. Meh. Anyway, let's look at the miraculous power of bananas. Yeah, that heals quite a bit. So, if zombie apocalypse happens, get some bananas. Oh, hello. Would you like some shotgun? Of course you do. Everybody loves shotgun, unless you're a zombie. Well, you only really love shotgun if you're on this side of it. I should name these zombies. You, since you're the only female-looking zombie, you can be Mommy Zombie. And you die. Name for the kid. The kid zombie. Oh, you can be Freddy Zombie. Because you kind of have a mask like Freddy. You have the, hockey mask on. I really have a name for you. I will leave it up to you to name him by the next episode that shows up. This being like 11 o'clock, that might be a while. Let's save our game at 5, and I'm getting through this a lot quicker than I did in the last part, but that's last time. And this is another way of death. We get eaten by either wild dogs or zombie dogs. He rubs his hands together, laughs at us, and it puts us back to the start because this game... It hates us a lot. So, little circles on the ground, don't step on those. They hate you. Surfer dude in the Speedo. I don't know. I can't think of a surfer dude zombie name. It's actually kind of difficult. You can be Uncle Ted zombie. I don't know why Uncle Ted, but you can be. You can be Daddy zombie. Because, yeah. I don't know either. There's a cave. Let's not go into there yet. And shoot surfer dude zombie. I gotta think of a better name than that. Hello, Freddy Zombie. Have some shotgun. Oh, boy. I'm in a freaking corner. Run away! I don't think you can run in this game either. Again, thankfully they are much slower than we are. Let's switch to the rifle since we're running out of ammo for the shotgun. And there is Jack Squat over here, so that was pointless. Also, when I go in here, if I come back out, they'll all be back, which is going to suck if I don't find some ammo. You're dead. Go away, Uncle Ted. No one loves you. Ooh, rifle ammo. Just what I wanted. Freddy Zombie. Whoa, bats. Vampire bats, it appears. Die? Holy crap. 35 life bat left? It hit me like once. Yes, coconuts heal you greatly, so if you're on an island full of zombies and you have coconuts, you might be fine. Then again, you might die horribly. Really? No? Gimme. 111, that's deep. Whoa! Is that all ammo? Die? No, surfer dude. No, thank you. Sorry, mommy zombie, but, I don't feel like letting you eat my brains today. Hello, Uncle Ted. What the? That must be the family pet. More of them. Yay. Wow, that's a lot of rifle ammo. That might last me a little while. I guess in the end, even if I have to kill all those zombies on the way out, I will still gain ammo in the end, so that's fine. As long as I don't come down here again. Okay! Needless to say, in this game there aren't many textures, which is kind of disappointing, but, oh, hello. Stop that. Not eat my tasty flesh. Thank you for shopping at S-Mart. Slow down. Uncle Ted, what have I told you about eating? Okay. We really need to kill him, but, well, next time we will go out either that way or that way, because I have no idea where I'm going. I do need to show one more death, however, and I've not cut this file, have I? This video file. Crap. Oh well. Let's save as 6. And I think the game just locked up, because it does that. Yay, it worked! Anyway, I will show you the scene. What happens when you leave? Taking the coward's way out? Yes! Blam. Any laughs at our suicide?